All right, guys, we're gonna check the drain hose of the IAG AOS air oil separator. It's down there, you can't see it yet. Let me remove some of this, remove the intercooler, and we'll have a closer look and I'll show you what's going on. All right, first thing, air oil separators. Yeah, AOS, air oil separator. I want to check it out. I just pulled off the intercooler. We're going to look at it in a minute. First, let me do the finger test here. If I remember right, there's always oil dripping on these things. So, what the hell? It's bone dry. Hold on. You know I don't play games. This is dead serious. What's in there? I'm gonna look at the view later. It looks pretty freaking dry. Every time I've done the OEM oil cooler, taking it off like in the old days, that rubber right there would be dripping oil. Maybe this thing works. You know, I was having thoughts about removing it, but I don't think so now, especially when I read about for ethanol vehicles, it's especially important. Let's just look at this grim speed here inside so I can get to the light right. Dude, I don't, what the hell? There's no oil even in the bottom of that bank. Let me see. Oh, it's heavy. Oh, I can't even lift it. Dude, that's spotless. In the bottom, you might not be able to get the, I can see the very bottom, there's not a drip of oil. Is that weird or something, or is that good? Is that normal? See that? Can't, it's hard to get the light down there. Dude, like, that pretty much is my commercial for AOS, I guess. I've never seen the boost duct, I mean, am I looking on the right side? Yeah, it would be in the charge pipe, right? That's the pressurized side. I don't know. You guys can school me if I'm wrong. I know that this is usually give me a bead of oil right here whenever I undid that. It's not there. Maybe this AOS is doing a huge job like it's meant to. That's almost like a bit of proof. You know, I was posting the other day about how can I prove it on a 2015 WRX Facebook page group. Maybe that's how I prove it. There's no oil seen in this system at all. Weird. Okay, drain hose. Now, it's probably a waste of time and there's probably nothing in it, but you, I want my peace of mind, you know? So if there's nothing in it, you just scored gold because you don't have to mess with yours at all and I just did all the dirty work. All right, so the drain hose. Now, you know, I'm still hella confused with all these goddamn, all these damn hoses, to be honest. It's just so confusing, man. But anyway, I do know that the two with the silver, top and bottom, are your coolant hoses that route coolant through this bar, heat the whole thing, which prevents a lot of that coagulation and slime and stuff from accumulating because it keeps it like the same temperature. Maybe it helps condensation, I don't know. But I know that those two are coolant. Those are the easy ones. And then everything else just starts getting confusing. These are oil lines, possibly. These are all PVC type lines, these three. And because one of them I know, two of these three right here, I mean, this isn't a technical discussion, don't worry. Two of these three go into this little Y thing down to your PVC. That they actually provided a PCV valve. I guess it's different than your stock one. It must be. But see, there's a little Y valve right there, if you can see it better than me. And the other one, the other of those three, winds around and is the one that goes, is that it? Yeah, the one that goes like in there. So it's some kind of PVC on top and I do believe these two are oil. You could catch me wrong, but I think these two are oil. One of them might be vapor, I don't know. What I do know is that this bottom one is the drain. So, the drain hose comes out of here into this Y. Well, see, I already proved myself wrong. All right, one of these three, this will be the most confusing video you ever seen. One of these three goes actually here to a 90 that my finger is underneath, a 90, which goes right here and ends. So it doesn't go to this Y. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and just take off this bottom. Shoot, I hope I can get the tire wraps back on that thing. I really don't wanna take the whole thing apart. We'll see what happens. I just wanna see if there's anything in these lines at all. And if there isn't, I guess I won't ever bother with this again, but I just wanna find out, you know. We have an issue, guys. That sucks. I unbolted it. Luckily, I did. Just to like lift it a bit and see what's going on. And I guess the camera bent up. And it seems like it's wet. It's wet under there, and I have a little pool in a corner down there somewhere. A little bit. But you can see some liquid, some moisture there. Now, I guess the obvious thing here is, that's oily. I was just thinking, you know how sometimes I smell the coolant? I was just going, wait a minute, is that where that's all coming from? But no, that's oil. That's not coolant, that's oil. So I basically, for now, one, I want to make sure this fitting is tight, and I might just check these Allens while I'm at it, especially on this edge of the, let me get you a better light. On the edge of the tank over there, see that? Right there, sort of. There's some moisture, something going on, which obviously is not that great for me. But I am gonna look for a few fixes, tighten a few things. It doesn't look like it's from this tie wrapped hose down there at all. It's either from, I might even see it on this hose. It's either from this block or from this fitting right here. I'm gonna check them all here. All right, so I couldn't really tighten the big one at all. It's pretty dang tight. I didn't really tighten these five, but I did. I got a little snapper on them, just a tiny, tiny click, but not really. They're pretty tight. And I did these two on the oil return hose too. And I'm just about to pull the oil return, so I wanted to video it. I don't think anything's gonna come out. That's what I thought. Nothing. Nothing out of the oil return, which is the very bottom of the tank. I don't like bending these up, but hey, it's temporary. It should be okay if I can get it back quick. All right, so swing this down to take the pressure off all those hoses. This is your oil. Let me get you a camera angle. My hand's stuck. Ah. So you have your oil return right here. You know, I mean, if I can't see anything in this, I'm not even gonna bother. This is a pain to work with. Let me, maybe I got a flashlight. Oh, I'll use my Ryobi, I guess. I mean, if it's spotless. Oh, it's not spotless. Look at all that white gunk. Okay, good. This was worth it. Now we're gonna take off the other end. We gotta see just how bad it is. So, I'm gonna just dive in and get that off that T-fitting. It's so tight. All right, guys. At least 20 minutes later, I got the hose off. Ooh. Let me get it out of here real quick before it drips. I think some dripping. Let me get First, let me see if it free drips or if it needs to be squirted. Okay. I should have used a white rag, sorry, that would have been better. That is some gunk. I mean, that's the same thing that you guys, you get with your catch cans, just like a little different. So, geez, if that hose has that much stuff, I wonder. I mean, I don't want to spray into the PVC, but you can probably see right here that in that hose probably has tons more. So, I mean, I'm not going to uninstall it at this time, though the thought crossed my mind, because it is doing stuff for that. I'll just ask, you know, find out people that know about these. Should you really take all this out? Now, this is a drain, so that means that's... Does that mean that's going into the oil, the yellow, this yellow junk, and it shouldn't be, or it should be, or that's normal, whatever, I don't know. Anyway, that's a good inspection. Kind of shows you something. Still got a cold. Shows you something that's going on with these. Let me grab some brake clean and spray this out real quick. Hold on. Nothing unusual, just cleaning out some of that gunk. And it'll wait for it to dry a minute. Now you can still even see some junk in there. See that? Of course, this seems kind of pointless because we just saw that this is all through the system. Changing one little hose, who knows? Anybody that has an IAG contact, go ahead and like link them up to this video or something when it's out. And just to get some thoughts on it. Is this normal? Is this not normal? I'm sure it is normal, basically. And I am going to keep an eye underneath this later for more oil leaks. And you know, that may... cross the line for me, but hopefully that took care of it, just tightening all those things just a tiny bit. And I guess I'd rather have that gunk in the tubes rather than in the engine, I guess is how you look at it. And this isn't head gasket stuff, don't be all confused. I can't do it now. I bet the oil, and if everybody takes off their oil cap, look underneath it, you'll probably see some of that white goo. It's called slime or whatever. There's some posts on it. Just spray it out and put it back. Forget about it. All right, that's it for now.